Now coming to your association with PPCL and Speed, India's first racer, F1 racer, endorses India's first branded fuel. The association has been since time immemorial, to be very specific, since 2004. You have seen the brand at its peak, its declining sales due to price difference between Speed and normal petrol, and its revival the last couple of years. Tell us more about your association. What do you see in Speed, and what makes you say you trust only Speed?
Well, obviously, as you said, 2004 was a very the initial stages of the launch of the Speed brand itself. So it's a brand that is very close to my heart. As you said, 2004, it's more than a decade I've been associated with the Speed brand. We've done many cool things together, and the brand itself is very cool right now. It's a great product, the best in the market right now. It is a very it's a clean fuel. It's very efficient for the engine. For the modern engines, obviously need a good nutrients like what we need for our body. So in Speed, we have the best of these nutrients for an efficient engine, and for a driver, the drivability becomes a lot smoother, and so on. So a lot of technology from the racetrack has gone into the development of the Speed fuel itself. So that's why racing is a proving ground for many technologies, including fuel, turbocharged modern engines, anti-lock braking systems, safety aspects, tires. The list goes on and on and on. So yes, of course, I believe in Speed, and Chennai also believes in Speed. So it's a great. The greatest endorsement is from the people of Chennai, and that's fantastic, I think.
Right, this brings me to another question. How is the F1 fuel different from the normal fuel, normal petrol?
Well, the octane rating is a bit different, but essentially the rule is such that you have to use pump fuel in a Formula One car. They use a different octane. It's a little bit higher octane because the engines are turbocharged and the compression ratios are quite high in a Formula One car. But apart from that, it's very similar to what we are using on the road right now.
Okay. So is P97 suitable for a Formula One car, or is that a higher rating octane?
Of course, with a little bit of tweaking, with bit more octane, it should be, yeah, it should perform as well as other fuels.
On this World Environment Day, I must ask you this question. The current positioning of Speed projects it as a cleaner version of petrol and is gaining momentum amongst the masses since it reduces emissions. What are your views on this?
As I previously said, the motorsport itself is going into a much cleaner environment. We are going green and so on. So, efficient engines need fuels that can perform as well as what they're designed for, and emissions are the norms today, and we have many challenges because emission standards are getting tougher and tougher. But we are up for the challenge, and we keep producing the best fuels out there in the market. So congratulations to all the team, the technical team as well. They've done a great job. That's all. These are facts, and this is something which is very evident in our fuels.
When coming to the technical details, how important is it to choose the right fuel for the car? So whether it's a normal petrol, Speed, or Speed 97, how do we as individuals make a decision, or how do we as dealers convince the customers about the right kind of fuel to choose for the car?
So, in America, typically, if you take that market, they sell fuels from 89 octane up to 104. So, in India, I think we start at more than 89, 91 octane. So, we already in Speed. We have a lot of these. We have a certain elements that make your car run much cleaner than the other fuels right now in the market. So, I mean, this, as I told you previously, it is, it's a very, you know, it's a clean fuel and it's an efficient, you know, your car runs more efficiently and so on. So, you know, there is no question of, you know, other fuels. You know.
Wind speed is
yes, up. Exactly.
Yeah. So with speed 97, it must be the higher compression ratio where the cars which require higher compression ratio, we must recommend speed 97.
So all the sports cars, all the high-end cars require a octane rating of more than 95, and because of the compression ratio, because of the turbocharging, because of the way it's designed, the modern engines, and you know, that's how you get the optimum power. And 97 will address all these problems. You will have a very, you know, a superb drive, and you get the most out of the engine basically, and the car's performance and the drivability and so many other factors.
What are your views on high-speed diesel? And so there are so many motorsport cars, high-end luxury cars which run on diesel. Do you think high-speed diesel is appropriate for them?
Yeah, we obviously, you know, the sulfur is a factor, and high-speed diesel was a great product. So I hope that you know, we can bring it again and you know, try and drive it.
Do you think speed is equally good for two-wheelers or it's just meant for cars?
Well, the engine design is the same, two-wheelers and four-wheelers. It's an overhead cam engine, 16 valves. You have the big bikes are very, very similar to what you drive in a car. So, of course, if it's good for a car, it's good for a bike as well.
So it basically cleans the engine, so whatever engine it is, it will lower the emissions.
It will lower the emissions, run more efficiently, the power delivery output, everything becomes a lot better. So
yeah. Sure.